Welcome to the Learning Center at JCU. In this session, we are going to discuss the third step in essay writing. This is how to read research. When reading a text, it is important to engage with the material as much as possible. A light or passive reading of the text will not provide the engagement that the mind needs to process material effectively. It is when we read actively that information is processed, understood, and retained in memory. Research suggests that active reading is essential to learning. There are a number of strategies we can use to help us actively engage when we read a text. These can be categorized as pre-reading tasks, during reading tasks, and post-reading tasks. When reading, it is useful to keep note of the bibliographical reference of each article you read in the correct referencing style for your discipline. If you fail to note the reference correctly the first time, you may have difficulty finding the article again when you need to include it in the reference list. It is also helpful to keep short notes on what you have read. These notes should be summaries in your own words. This is because when you refer to your notes later on, you are more likely to understand notes in your own words than in language and phrases which are unfamiliar to you. It is also a key point in active reading. If you can restate the idea in your own words, you really understand it. If you cannot, it is likely you haven't understood the ideas fully. Some students like to write a one-sentence summary of each paragraph. Others prefer to keep dot points. It doesn't really matter which method you adopt, but rather that you take notes in a way that makes sense to you and which you can easily understand when you return to your notes later. It is also a good idea to keep a separate list of great quotes from an article with page numbers, as well as key data and statistics. This will be useful as evidence to support your argument when you begin writing your essay. There are two main types of texts that you are likely to encounter when doing research. These are journal articles and textbooks. Although we use similar strategies to read both, there are some differences. For a journal article, it is best to understand the abstract first. This provides the main overview of the article. Next, read the conclusion. This will state the main findings. These two sections will provide a quick and efficient overview of the main content of the article. At this point, you may realize that the article is not relevant to your research. If that is the case, you may put it aside and move on to another article. If the article is relevant to your research, the next step is to read the titles or headlines and the topic sentences throughout the article. This will provide a more solid overview of the entire text. It will also inform you where you can find the key information you will need. This is more efficient than reading the article word by word from the front to the back, hoping to find the information that you need. Often, in undergraduate subjects, the lecturer will assign a textbook as a key text. We perform an overview reading in a similar way to reading a journal article. First, we read and summarize the introduction and conclusion. Usually, textbooks will contain discussion questions at the end of the chapter. If we read these first, they can be used to identify the key themes that will be discussed in the text. Next, we scan any headings in the text and read the topic sentences. In this way, we construct a skeleton or outline of the text before we read in more depth. This will also help us to identify any key terms or information that we need to look up and understand before we read the text in more depth. And that is step 3, how to read research.